Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Krishnaveni, third year radiology postgraduate from Arugudai Vida Medical College, Pondicherry. Title for my paper presentation is Role of CT in Primary Oral Cavity Cancer with Clinical, Surgical and Histopathological Correlation. Objective of the study is to determine the accuracy of CT in primary oral cavity cancers with clinical, surgical and histopathological correlation to determine the accuracy of CT in assessing the metastatic nodal disease in these patients with clinical, surgical and histopathological correlation. This is a prospective study done on 63 patients. The study period was from November 2020 to September 2021. All patients who underwent CT for oral cavity cancer who have undergone surgery with clinical and pathological correlations. Patient with previous radiation to the head and neck and patient with any head and neck surgery were excluded. So coming to the results, on age-wide distribution, it is most commonly seen in 61 to 70 years of 25.4% and 41 to 50 years of 25.4% and least commonly seen in 21 to 30 years. On gender-wise distribution, it is most commonly seen in females. And distribution of the study patient based on their location, it is most commonly seen in the buccal mucosa, followed by gingivobuccal sulcus, heart palate, etc. So distribution of study patient based on their habits is most commonly seen in patients who's having tobacco, followed by tobacco, betel, and smoking. So diagnostic accuracy of CT scan surgery and clinical assessment versus HPE detecting the actual patient with T1 condition showed a sensitivity of 62% in surgery and clinical 50%, specificity of 96.4% and positive predictive value of 71.4 in surgery and clinical assessment 66 and negative predictive value of 94.6 in surgery and accuracy is 92.1 in surgical assessment and clinical assessment is 90.5%. On T2 condition, the sensitivity was 66.7% in surgery and 55.6 in clinical. Specificity was 88.9 in surgery and clinical assessment, it was 83.3%. And positive predictive value, 81.8 in surgery and in clinical assessment, it is 71.4%. And negative predictive value is 78.1% and 71.4% with an accuracy of 79.4% in the surgery and 71.4% in clinical assessment. On a T3 condition, the sensitivity was low in surgery and clinical assessment. Specificity was high and positive predictive value of 50% seen in surgical assessment and 25% in clinical assessment. Negative predictive value of 82.5% and 80% was seen. On accuracy, 79.4% was seen in surgery and 73% seen in clinical assessment. On T4 condition, followed by the N1 condition where we saw the sensitivity is 62.5% in surgery and clinical assessment. Specificity was high in surgery and positive predictive value also high in surgery, followed by negative predictive value is more seen in 94.3% and 92.7% and the accuracy was 87.3% in surgery and 68.3% in clinical assessment. On N2A condition, it was sensitivity was 0%, positive predictive value was 0%, with accuracy of 65.2% seen in surgical assessment and 64.8% is seen in clinical assessment. On N2B condition, sensitivity was 72.7% in surgical and 55% in clinical assessment, a specificity of 65.4% seen in surgery and 92.3% seen in clinical assessment. Positive predictive value of 30.8% is seen in surgery and 60% is seen in clinical assessment. Negative predictive value of 92% is seen in surgery and clinical assessment of 90% was seen. Accuracy was clinical assessment, it was 85.7%. On N2C condition, the accuracy was high, specificity was high and the negative predictive value was high. Sensitivity was 50% and positive predictive value is 50%. N3 condition, sensitivity was 0 in diagnosing accuracy of CT scan and 100% in clinical and surgical assessment. And again, specificity was high in all three. Negative predictive value was high in all three. And accuracy was 64.8% in the CT scan and 100% in the surgical and clinical assessment. In our study, the primary tumor size and soft tissue involvement were identified with 95 to 100% accuracy by CT scan of the head and neck region, whereas surgical and clinical accuracy were 78 to 92% and 70 to 90% respectively. The accuracy of detection bone involvement by CT scan of head and neck in this study was 93%, whereas by intraoperative and clinical assessment, it was found to be 73%. So conclusion, CT scan of head and neck has the highest sensitivity, specificity, and accuracy in assessing the tumor size, surrounding soft tissue and bone involvement along with nodal metastasis. Thus, preoperative TN staging by CT of head and neck is very important in detecting accurate stage of the carcinoma of oral cavity when compared to clinical and surgical stage. On coming to case one, we can see a clinical photograph and postoperative specimen image in a patient with left buccal carcinoma. Axial CECT image shows an irregularly enhancing lesion in the left buccal mucosa. On case 2, we can see the clinical image showing right exophytic buccal mucosa lesion. In contrast enhanced CT axial section, we can see the mass in the right submandibular lymphadenopathy, and a gross specimen image showing the resected primary tumor. In case 3, we are seeing the clinical photograph showing lesion in the right gingivobuccal sulcus and the intraoperative image while performing neck dissection. An axial CECT image showing the enhancing mass in the gingivobuccal sulcus causing destruction of the mandible. On case 4, CECT axial image shows left gingivobuccal sulcus lesion with extension into the infratemporal fossa causing destruction of the mandible. And we can see the postoperative resected specimen image. Case 5 shows the lesion in right lateral border of the tongue. On axial CECT image, we can see the enhancing lesion in the right lateral border of the tongue with the bilateral cervical lymph adenopathy. Case 6 shows CECT axial section showing solid enhancing lesion in the lower lip of the on the left side. On intraoperative image shows a resected margin of the lesion. On case 7, clinical image shows a lesion in the heart palate. CECT axial image showing enhancing lesion in the heart palate causing destruction of the anterior aspect of the heart palate. On cross references, Close et al. Evaluated 60 patients and found that 88% were correctly evaluated by clinical examination, which was similar to our results. Vandenbroek et al. Reported 62% accuracy of clinical examination in predicting bone involvement with a low sensitivity and high specificity, which was significantly lower than our study. These are my references. Thank you.